Welcome back. Today we will discuss on fundamentals of spatial filtering. It's one of the basic principal operation is used in digital image processing operation. Okay. In fact, for the most of the operations, what we perform on an image will be based on the technique. Now, when we the few techniques, what we say is a filter. The filtering will be like a low pass filter, high pass filter, or band pass, band reject, many kind of filtering operations to be performed on image processing by using the corresponding technique. If I say with a filter, you require a kernel or a template or a window. Okay, all will be same name. Means, for example, I have an image, F image. Let us consider F image. If I want to perform a filter, it may be low pass filter or a high pass filter. Let us consider I want to perform a high pass filter, H. High pass filter, okay. As you can see, as you might have seen in your digital signal processing, you use with a equation, correlation and convolution. We use input signal, and we use a sampling coefficient. What we call is a filter. What we call is a template. This is what the H, what I am performing is a high pass filter. We are using with a kernel. It's a kernel will be passing it on the F. On the F. F is nothing but your image. And it will be getting processed on the image by step. So that the output after performing a step by step operation on an image, total whole image, you will end up with a process. That process, what we call is a filter. Then the output what we are getting it from the filter, it may be high pass or it may be low pass. Okay. Now let me see with in detail how the process will be operated. Okay. Let us consider, I hope it is visible for you, image. Okay, I have an image, you can see here. This is an image. This is an image. What is that? And the image will be divided into small segments, what we call as a pixel. And all the pixels are arranged in rows and columns. This will be your x axis. This will be your y axis. Okay. I hope the point is clear. Okay. Now, you can see. I'll make it more visibility for you. Okay. There is an image in which it is arranged in the form of rows and columns. Okay. And I call this as F. And what the equation I am using? Okay, let us take that H. H is nothing but what we call is a sampling coefficient, or what we call as a window, and this window will be getting a slide on the image, because it will be getting covered up, or it will be getting moved onto the all the pixels. And when it is moving on the all the pixels, it will be performing certain operation, and from the certain operation you are getting an output. That output will be depends on a application what we are using, either it will be high pass or a low pass. This is what the process. Okay. Now you can see. Okay. Now I hope in the image. Okay. I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 rows are shown. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 rows and 8 columns. Okay. Now I call here F. Okay, I hope you can see this is something like a window. what we call as a kernel, it will be, what is the size of the kernel now? Okay, what is the size of your image is 8x8. But your window is not 8x8, it is a 3x3. Okay, because 3 rows and the 3 column. Okay, now it will be getting placed on all the pixel. I hope you understood. This window, W window, it will be placed on a window. Sorry, on the image. Okay, like this. Okay, now initially it will be placed here. Okay, for example. It will be placed here in this location. Okay. Now, once if you place here, how many rows are covered here? Now, what is the size of the W here? 3x3 means how many pixels are covered here? 3 pixels horizontal, 3 pixels vertical. 3x3 pixels are covered. Okay. Now, when it perform a operation, okay, because I have covered only 3x3 pixel. Okay, now I had to move it, I had to shift by one row right side, one column right side. Okay, further you have to move to the one row below also. Okay, that I'll come to you. Okay, one column right side. Okay, if I move it one column right side bit here, means I'm covering by like this. Okay. For example, I'll show here. Okay, it is initially these three will be covered. Okay, next one. Okay, which are those? Okay, what you have to do? You have to shift it right one column. Okay. Now you how many will be covered here? Again 3 will be covered. Okay, because I could not able to make it clear for you here. Okay, 3. Again you shift one column. Okay, like this. Okay, or else. Three here, okay, next, 3 here, next, because 3 will be covered up, next, 3 will be like this, so that it will be getting shifted here. Okay, now when it will be, means the window will be getting shifted in horizontal, means what we call as a scanning. Okay, now when it reaches here at the end, okay, look at this one. When it reaches at the end point here, okay. Now, as when how you are going now, window, the window will be going in the right side, means you are shifting it one column. Okay, once you reach here at the end, at this point, say, once you reach at this point, last, what you have to do? Now, you have to take it one shift down, means one row will be shifted down. So, which are the points will be covered, or these 3x3 will be covered here. Look at this, earlier it was shifting by the right side, one column. When it reaches at the end here, you have to stop. Again, you have to come down. Now, when you're coming down, now you have to shift from the top one row below. Means the first row is already scanned. Again, you have to proceed like this. How long you have to do it now? Until you reach to the end of the screen. How you are going again now? Horizontally. Okay, what will happen when you complete, when you reach at the end here, what you have to do? Again you have to shift it down like this. So this process will be completed and it will be getting scanned throughout the image. How many pixels? 3x3. Because it has mentioned with like a, what is the window size here? 3x3. Okay, I'll come to the point also why we have chosen a 3x3. Okay. Now, what you can see here is the image F here, and this will be like a W. Okay, what is nothing but here W is a kernel, F is an image, and W will be moved, or it will be getting placed onto the F, and it will perform an operation. Okay, when it is a performing operation, we will see the locations of each F and the W. Okay, what are the operations it will perform actually? Okay. Now, when I say, okay, I hope you can see W, what is the size of the W? 3x3. We call this is a center pixel. Its location will be W 0, 0. I told it is a 0, 0. And how we are going here? This way it will be x-axis, this way y-axis. X-axis and the y-axis. If this is a center pixel, if you move one bit right, one bit, okay, means it's adjacent pixel. What will be the coordinate of that? Okay, in what direction you are moved? In y direction you are moved. Okay, which is constant? X is constant, 0, 1. Hope you understood. Okay, now similarly, if you shifted to the left side, that is, means I'm talking about the coordinates of a W now. Coordinates of W, now you are going to the left side with respect to the center pixel. You need to be talk with respect to the center pixel. Now what are the coordinates of center pixel? 0, 0. Then which side you have moved? You have moved into the left side. Which axis will be changing? Is it x axis or y axis? Y axis will be changing. How much it will be changing? It is changing with a minus 1. Means what will be the coordinates of the 0, minus 1. Hope you understood. Okay. Now, similarly, if you go up, okay, if you go up this position, okay, now same here, this will be x-axis, this will be y-axis with respect to the center pixel. How you are moving? You are going in vertically up. Which axis is changing? X-axis is changing. How it is changing? Minus 1, means what are the coordinate of this? -1, -1, 0. Similarly, if you go down from the with respect to center pixel, what will be the coordinate of that? 1, 0. Which will be changing? X is changing. So I made it 1, 0. Okay. Now similarly, if you go in diagonally, okay, let us take that diagonal of this one. Okay. Which coordinates are changing? X is also changing. Y is also changing. What are the coordinates of this? 1, 1. Similarly, if you go in this way, okay, I'm just going in all the direction. If I go in this direction, which coordinate will be changing? W. Okay. Now which will be decreasing? Y will be decreasing. Which is increasing? X is increasing. What is the coordinate of this? 1, -1. Okay. Now similarly, if you go in this direction, now you tell me. Okay, which are the coordinates will be increasing or decreasing? X will be decreasing, Y is also decreasing. What will be the coordinates of that? 1, -1 with respect to the center pixel. Hope you understood this one. Similarly, okay, if I take a F, this is what the W, this is what like a coordinates of a W, which is mentioned here. Similarly, if I consider a same F here, F of xy, the right side of this F of x comma y plus 1. The left will be F of x y minus 1, F of above F of x minus 1 y, below this one F of x plus 1 y, this way. These are the coordinates of F. F means this is image. Now image is now represented by F, and your kernel is now represented by W. Okay. Now with F, with respect to this F, F of
x plus 1, y minus 1, f of x plus 1, y plus 1, f of x minus 1 and y minus 1, f of x minus 1, y plus 1. Okay. Now, in the kernel operation, what we can see, this will be getting overlapped and it will be getting multiplied. Okay. In the last hour, I told what kind of multiplication or what kind of like array product you are doing it now. What is the bit by bit product? Means 0th bit of this one, 0th bit of this one is multiplied with this 0 bit. This bit is multiplied with this bit. This one, like this. Okay. Now, let us assume that you might have known that there is a digital signal processing convolution. Okay. Now, after the product, the 0, this pixel will be multiplied with this one, this will be multiplied with this one. Like this, if I multiply, I just sum it out, f of x comma y, w of x comma y, x and y are different. Means I will multiply and I sum it up, whatever the result you are getting. You multiply this each bit by bit, you are getting a resultant sum. That resultant sum is reflected onto the center pixel. I hope the point will be clear for you. Okay, I will just repeat for you. Okay. Now, there is a convolution. Now, there is like a convolution. What I maintained? F multiplied by W because of product of this. Each bit of this W00 is multiplied by F of 00, W of 01 is multiplied by F of X plus F of X comma Y plus 1. Like this, if it is multiplied, you will end up here some kind of like answer. Say, let us take that A1. This A1, it will be replaced with the center pixel. Whichever the center pixel I have moved here. Okay, look at this one. Here I have moved like this 3x3 pixel. The center pixel value will be replaced by A1. The center pixel value will be replaced by A1. Okay. Now, same way, if you move this one in the next, okay, how I told in the previously, one column horizontal, okay, again the center pixel will be replaced by product of F and W. Okay. I hope it is a quite a difficult task for you to understand this one. It is something like, okay, you are just putting a paper on the full paper. Okay, you consider that a paper, you make a 10 by 10 rows and column on a paper, and you take a small paper of a size 3x3. Okay, if I ask you to scan it, what you do on the 10 by 10 rows of a paper, you keep 3x3 paper. Right? I hope you understood this one. Keep a 3x3 paper, okay, where you keep it now? Very first left corner. Now, you assume that, okay, you are performing some operation here. This is a 10 by 10 paper, you are performing some operation here. What is the size of the small paper? 3x3. 3x3 matrix. And after performing, you'll get like one answer. That answer you'll be replaced with a center pixel. Okay, that center pixel. Now how many pixels you have covered here? Total 3x3 pixel of a image, means of the full paper. Now I had to cover it up full paper. Now what you do? You just take that small paper, there is a 3x3 paper, you shift it up. How you have to shift it? You have to shift it towards the right side. Again you perform operation.
whatever the operation result is there, you replace with like a center pixel. Like this, if you do it and if you cover it up for the full image, okay, there is a small changes, there the change will be occurred for all the images except your boundary. I give an exception, except your boundary, all the pixels will be getting modified, and after modification, that will be nothing but the one of the application operation you have performed. Either it will be like a high pass, or it may be low pass, or it may be like addition, subtraction, or any kind of operation, that is a convolution, correlation, any. Okay, so this is what the basic spatial operations is involved, or is operated on the image by using a kernel. It's a template. So which is the basic component is required for the spatial filtering is your template. Okay, this template is a standard. It is defined by few of the operators. We call name a few: Laplacian, okay, Gaussian. These are the some of the filters will be named. They are the standard filters are available through which you are operating and you are getting here. Okay, in further class also you can understand how it will be given and how the process will be happening. Okay, I hope the point is clear for you. Okay, now I'll end up the today's class in which you learnt about the spatial operation of an image.